Hey everybody, this is Rydo, and we are back with another episode, hopefully the last episode of the Talos Principle. Well, at least the last episode for a good long time, and I own the game now. I might as well revisit it at some point in the future, maybe. So you'll notice that I still am missing a gold star. I have been I've been everywhere. It's not in any of the lands. It's in this island, this boarded up one on sea. I rechecked the that's just awful. Sorry for coughing. I looked up the strategy guide and basically had to do a find on page to find where the last location was. And why I didn't think of that, probably about an hour ago when I stopped the last recording, I don't know. But gosh, that just sounds horrible. This just started too. I mean, I was peacefully sitting here, not coughing much at all. And that's cool. An actual head with a statue of the head. Look, another head. They spent an effort to make some people dead. Two lovers are separated by the abyss of time and space, yet true love knows no obstacles. This is cool. Strategy guide says to do before. My first instinct is just to walk off. Yep, this is the good old fashioned Indiana Jones path between the two lines. Pretty simple, even. Dead beaten path here. That's cool. They did. They made a face here. Why couldn't they make faces on any of those other statues? Was that supposed to just be a red herring? Was that the trick? That it was just supposed to be a red herring? No faces. I don't know what red herring though. Because if you go in the options and you play the third person mode, to begin with, you know you're a robot. It shows you even in first person mode, right at the beginning that you're a robot, so any attempt of Elohim or anybody else to claim that humans never existed, seems silly. Finally, we found the 10th piece. I was half walking around. I went to every single place and checked the signs, like I said, and then I couldn't find it there. I was half walking around the playing the Sigils of Elohim game. So I got about halfway through with that to get some extra stars. And I guess I can give a quick review of that. It's just more of the Tetris puzzles. So if you really loved the Tetris puzzles in this game and wanted to do more. Go get the Sigils of Elohim game for Android or iOS. It's free. If you love these, you can get some more of these. I don't hate these. I think these are... They're just some game mechanics, in my opinion, that don't qualify as actual game mechanics anymore. And I guess this is just one of those. Tetris, if you were gonna go buy a Tetris game, it would do a lot more than just this today. Noisy, these puzzle pieces. I might as well just answer the question, the what's the rush question. Why do I feel a need to continue recording while I'm under the weather? Why am I not just not recording anything? And the answer is pretty simple. I'm just really, really far behind. In my mind. In actuality, I'm really, really, far ahead, but I feel like I'm behind. I'm behind for a lot of reasons. I'm behind because I should have started recording a YouTube channel 3, 4, 5 years ago. It never occurred to me to do that, but it's what I should have done. What I feel like I should have done, at least. There's games that are still worth putting out a series, I feel like. Games that I love, or at least significantly like, that I want to, I would like to have a series out about them, and put some coverage on them, even if they are actually pretty old games. Like, this piece has become the spoiler piece. See, it says 47 million resources found, and it's showing you like 3 or 4 of them, and none of them are super random. Pause now if you want to read this. With the sore throat as I have right now, I'm glad I quit earlier to stop reading. Tetraminos. Didn't make sense. they make perfect sense either, and they're just blatant. There's no, not even a second worth of doubt that the ending that they show you, either ending, isn't exactly what is really happening in this world. If they were gonna make a Talos Principle 2, they could throw a big old monkey wrench in there and retcon the whole thing and just have a human being wake up out of a virtual reality machine, and then it could be a game within a game. I guess that would be a slight improvement. Oh, here they are. Kept wandering around. I'm like, where is this?
Thank you.
I didn't have it really. About the programs before, Uriel, Sheepdog, all of them, where they couldn't or chose not to come out to the real world. Uriel in specific decided to be a messenger and stay. Is that what we're doing when we are reincarnating ourselves? The next version, when we take to heaven, the ending, are we becoming a messenger? I don't think so. kind of a special puzzle. I won't reveal the surprise for you until later, but... That's why this puzzle's been so weird. We were spelling out a word. It's N-E-X-U-S, the name of the puzzle. Man, I am high up. Like, you could get to the top of that, almost. Another piece, one more piece. Just to walk in here, Nexus. What is the name of the puzzle? That's what we were doing the whole time. And yes, I'm a lousy cheater because I saw that while I was looking for stars, I oversaw it. I mean, I cannot turn a blind eye. As soon as I see something, I will enter my knowledge at least a little bit. Doesn't mean I will remember it, though. I have photographic evidence of that one. Take this and do what? Maybe come over here. See if perhaps If I could get a little bit higher, let's say a brick, I can have him walk around with this thing. Sure. Let's give ourselves a minute. We don't want to not give ourselves enough time. I'm recording myself. About a program. Follow me and do what I did. And it has apparently no free will whatsoever. Door open, but I need this to actually work. So it'd probably be better if I didn't connect those. Now what I can do is take the copy, and then once this gate's done, but that won't work, because as soon as I pick up this part, oh well. If he walked over here and then did what? So he needs to walk over here and to help me jump one of these fences? Jump one of these fences. think this will work. Now, what do I want to do? Maybe I can jump. That looks like I could actually jump over that. Well, I stayed on. one out in beta testing, I'm sure. I could jump over here for what little that's worth. Maybe if I put a box right in front of the shield. Let's see. No. Maybe I could have done that, but... didn't matter. So, 5 seconds to go. And then this recording will go bye-bye. Doesn't matter. I could take this and try to do something with it, but there isn't a lot I could do. If I try and zigzag it here, then it won't hit any of the charges. It would be gone. I suppose I could put it right where I am. See if I walk next to this thing. Nope, don't walk that way. Actually, I kinda do. Too tall. Thank you. I'm thinking right here. One second, let me take a few seconds break to try and take a cough suppressant. Drink some water. The shadow of the old reflector, then we can stick the current reflector in some kind of pattern so it doesn't, we don't lose it. That should be enough time. I hope this works. To redo some progress here. Not fun. We are on our final puzzle piece. That is good news. Sorry. For everybody that has to listen to this, I need a push to talk button. I have a switch, it's too dangerous to use. It's not like a push to talk button. Anyways, it's a switch, I have a mute switch. There's nothing any that special about it. Alright. have that play anymore. If I could get... No, you gotta get it right here, at the very least. That thing needs to glow a little bit brighter. So stand here. I'm not gonna re-record it. We'll just do it. Stand here. Stand here. Jump up here. If he needs to jump to here, I think I can, and then I can place the transmitter. And then from placing the transmitter, I just need to give it enough time to allow the recording of charging of that, and then I can get the peas. And now let's see. When it hits play, there will be a blue one. There, so I need to take this and put it right back where it goes. And really, this can just stay wherever it wants, but we'll just try and be tidy. Got one ready. There's no way I could really connect the other. So he's gonna come and stand here, but that's not the first. We don't want to do it the first time, we want to do it the second time. So I could place it on there. But he hasn't moved the block. So he's got to move the block first. Just about figuring that out in the recording. See, I dropped the platform. That would have messed us up. Trapped in there. Good thing I have a minute to spare too, because this is gonna go away and then it would be a little bit more difficult. A little bit more difficult to exit, but not really. We've got all the pieces. We now know what the code is. We knew it as soon as we got in here. It is 8. We saw the 8 and then star star on the first one. 5, I believe, and then 9. So that is the code for my run. And it's randomly generated. I love that that it's randomly generated. Any game today should have it randomly generated. There's no reason, unless you want that to be a part of the game, that people on the internet will just tell you the codes to unlock areas. There's no reason to not have it randomly. Really, there was very little reason to not have a random before. Random functions aren't a new thing. But they used to sell walkthroughs that make games impossibly difficult, specifically so you could turn around and sell a walkthrough. Doesn't look like anybody's gonna say anything to me. I tried to lock floor zero just to see what it would do, and nothing. And the auxiliary stairway, which we never found an auxiliary stairway. So, what that is all about, who knows. Anywho, that is the end of this episode. We went kinda long. Next episode should be it. Got number 6 unlocked. So next episode, we go to number 6. We go to floor 6. That should be the final ending. We've gotten all the stars. We did it legitimately. We didn't have to do the Sigils of Elohim iPhone Android game to get some stars. That was the backup plan. We've gotten all the white puzzle pieces. We've gotten all the puzzle pieces. We've done as much as we can really do. I haven't had a lockup in a long time. Maybe we fixed that. Maybe I've just gotten lucky. I don't know. Still, we have some stuttering issues. I've noticed in a couple of places while playing stuttering. You might notice that too. But I don't mind stuttering anywhere as much as I mind lockups and crashes. So maybe we kind of fix that. I'm hoping. Speaking of updates, since nobody was, I'm playing this like a week after an update was released for the Talos Principle. It wouldn't surprise me if in another week or so, another update comes by, and then another week and another week. I cannot guarantee that, but with the error issues, keep your eyes peeled for updates. If updates come back and they say we fixed locking, we fixed stuttering, we fixed improved performance, all of that, then yeah, that would be a indicator to maybe get this game if you're borderline on this. I mean, we played it from beginning to end, so this is not a functional game. It just had a little bit of problems. That's it for this episode. I said that before, I'm sure. As always, I ask that you like, share, subscribe, comment if you want to, and watch every second of my videos, because all of that helps me out. If you want to follow me on Twitter, I am at Rydo of All. That is R-Y-D-O-O-F-A-L-L. Have a good evening.